I am not sure what goes through your mind when you see news reports like these on the property market around the world, including Singapore. Some of us could still be rooted in self-denial and profound disbelief as the trains of real estate seem to be rushing past us while you're still thinking whether to board the next train, if there is still any left. In this video, let me extract some facts and numbers to help you adjust to the reality of the property market in Singapore. Alright, first let us examine some recent sales numbers. We notice that the appetite for higher value new homes have increased, both in terms of the total price quantum, as well as in the PSF prices of the homes purchased. If you compare the per square foot prices of homes sold in April 2021 with that of the year 2020, you will notice that the average PSF prices in all categories of properties in OCR, RCR and CCR have all increased. In fact, if you look at the higher range of both RCR and CCR, more than 3,000 PSF and even 4,000 PSF has already been widely accepted by the market. For buyers who have certain price constraints and still aspire to own a property in, say, the core central region, my advice is for you to really act fast, within realistic expectation in terms of property size and price. Otherwise, you could find yourself soon to be priced out of the area that you have always aspired to reside in. Next, let me break down the purchasers' profiles in different price categories, comparing year 2020 versus April 2021. You will also notice that a large percentage of the buyers are Singaporeans. Foreigners have dropped, obviously due to the COVID travel restrictions. Another point to note is that Singapore PR purchasers entering the market in the upper range of prices have increased by a huge percentage. In fact, many tenants who have been staying in Singapore for a while have noticed the progress of Singapore and the resilience of the Singapore property market have made the move to invest in Singapore properties. Many of them who had stayed for more than 10 years have told me that they have missed the previous boats and do not want to miss the next wave again. It is also important to note that the percentage of CCR transactions over the total new homes transactions have also increased over the past year. More people are buying into the core central region. This is in line with the government's efforts to bring its focus back to the central area and transform the CCR through many master plan initiatives. And apparently buying into areas of growth with continual demand is key to your real estate investment strategy. In fact, if you look at the property price index, it is evident that the market has strongly rebounded from the low in Q2 2017 to the current level. Apart from the slight dip during the onset of COVID-19 in Q1 2020, the market has seen remarkable demand for the past four quarters with an increase of 6.3%. We expect this trend to continue due to decreasing supply and continuous strong demand. I have shot another video with more detailed analysis of the supply and demand, so do check out my YouTube channel Singapore Property TV for that video. This chart here illustrates the number of new homes that were sold pre- and post-circuit breaker period. As we can see, during the initial phase of circuit breaker when movements and business operations are very restricted, only two projects were launched, and an average of 571 units per month were sold, many of which via virtual viewings and online presentations. As we progressed into second half of 2020, 12 projects were launched, and we sold an average of 1,045 units per month. In the first 4 months of 2021, 8 projects were launched, and an average of 1,181 units per month were sold. As you can see, buyers were committing to purchases at our show flats, and the demand has been consistently strong. Then, in phase 2 heightened alert in May till mid-June of 2021, movement and show flat capacity was again constrained. Now, as we enter the second half of 2021 with a more relaxed phase 3, we believe the pickup rate for July and August to average around 1,200 units per month, due to some exciting launches coming on board. What's important to note is that we are now way past the pre-circuit breaker numbers and going strong moving forward. Let's also take a look at the rate of sales of the projects that were launched in recent years. This table shows the 10 best-selling projects in 2020 and the respective remaining inventory. These projects were mainly launched between 2018 and 2020, and you notice that as of 18 June 2021, 87.6% of the 10,671 units have been sold. In fact, if you were to visit many of these projects, you will realize that you have limited choices left for you to cherry pick. Hence, the lesson learned. Don't wait if you see something suitable in your property search. There will never be a 100% perfect property. Let's take a closer look at how fast the buyers are buying up the projects launched in 2021. This table shows the number of units sold in the month of launch of each project. You can see that the percentage goes as high as 98% sold within the month of launch. Cumulatively, 48% of the units launched were sold within the first month. When we look beyond the first month, the total number of units sold has already crossed 63.4%. These numbers have proven to you that the market is driven by very strong demand and the supply of homes is falling fast. In fact, over the next 2 years, we are anticipating around 50,000 HDB flats hitting the minimum occupation period, which mean that these owners will be eligible to sell their HDB homes and potentially progress to the EC and private residential market, creating another surge of demand for private homes. Notice that in 2019 and 2020, we sold close to 10,000 units each year, and in just the first 5 months of 2021, more than half of those numbers have already been sold. So this year, I believe we should be selling over 10,000 units easily. The supply in 2022 of 7,400 units are estimated based on the assumption that all the en bloc and government land sale sites are all taken up by the developers. Realistically though, it may not be possible that developers will consume every site. But even with that very optimistic assumption, we are only anticipating 7,400 new homes coming into the market in 2022. So if you compare 7,400 units and the rate that new homes are being sold now, it is reasonable to predict that the unsold supply will reduce even further. I hope this video offers you enough insights to understand that if you are serious in the market to buy a property in Singapore, it does not benefit you at all to be indecisive with an expectation that is out of sync with the market. There is a lot of liquidity in the market now, and foreign buyers have yet to come in very strongly due to travel restrictions. You can imagine the market when the economy and COVID situation improve further and more foreign funds pour into Singapore. Some of us may have missed the earlier trains, but the good news is that you are still able to catch the next departing one. Do not wait till the last train leaves. I am PK So, and I produce educational and marketing videos on the Singapore property market. Please visit my website SingaporeProperty.tv for more insights. Many viewers have reached out to me after watching my videos and benefited from the suggestions that I had offered them. Please like and share this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel Singapore Property TV so that you won't miss out on future episodes. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to meeting you soon.